Look, pregnancy is such a special and wonderful moment in a woman's life, but some of that magical feeling can be replaced with a mixture of concern and anxiety if you are pregnant and taking medication for your Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. How do you know which medications are safe to take, and why are some safer than others during pregnancy? Well, I'll be going over those questions in this video, so keep watching to find out. Welcome back to my channel, the only place for Crohn's and colitis tips, tricks, and information. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a video. And if you want to join the exclusive community of people who receive my personal tips and tricks on living with Crohn's and colitis, then make sure you sign up to my newsletter by visiting the link in the description box below. As mentioned, pregnancy is such a special and wondrous event, which is why it caught my attention and I went on to do a master's in reproductive medicine, spending a few years working in pregnancy and fertility research before becoming a radiographer. Now, before we get into things, always remember it's important to discuss any concerns you have with your doctor and your IBD team, and to have regular antenatal checkups to ensure you and your baby are doing well. So let's get started with a few of the medications then. Number one is biologics. So these include infliximab, adalimumab, golimumab, vedolizumab, and ustekinumab. With infliximab and adalimumab, there is still being research done on the effects of these medications while pregnant, but it looks like that it's being suggested that the risks are low for the first 6 months of pregnancy at least, but these drugs should only be used during pregnancy if absolutely necessary, and your doctor will be able to decide on this. Pharmaceutical companies that do produce these drugs have advised that you should use contraception when on infliximab and adalimumab, and even up to 6 months after stopping the medications, as your child may be more at risk of getting infections. It's also important to know that if you have been on infliximab or adalimumab and have had a baby, that you tell your doctors and nurses, because your child shouldn't be given live vaccinations until after they are older than 6 months. Now, with vedolizumab, it's currently not recommended to be on it when pregnant unless your doctor has decided that the benefits of being on it outweigh the risk to you and your child. Again, your doctors will be the best place to get information on this and to make these decisions. Number two is immunosuppressants. So some immunosuppressants such as azathioprine and mercaptopurine are considered okay to be taken when pregnant by doctors, especially if they are keeping you in remission and healthy, as there could be a risk to the health of your baby if you stop them and become unwell. Now, methotrexate is also an immunosuppressant and should not be taken if you are trying to conceive, and that goes for both men and women. And if you are pregnant, it can increase the risk of birth defects. It is suggested that if you have been told to stop using methotrexate, then you need to use contraception for between 3 to 6 months. For mycophenolate, mofetil, you should not be on it if pregnant, as it can cause miscarriages and birth defects. And usually, if you are trying to conceive, you'll be advised to wait 6 weeks before trying to conceive. Next is antibiotics. Now, these aren't really treatments for IBD per se, but they are used to help treat infections caused by IBD complications. If you are on antibiotics such as metronidazole, then doctors consider it to be low risk during pregnancy. And lastly, when it comes to some over-the-counter medications that can help with some of the symptoms of Crohn's and colitis, care should be taken, and you should always consult your doctor before taking them anyway. So some antidiarrheals are safe to take during pregnancy, but some like loperamide might be linked to birth defects if taken during the first 3 months of pregnancy. Some antispasmodics like buscopan should also be avoided during pregnancy. And with everything I've mentioned in this video, it's really important to discuss these with your doctor first and your IBD team for the proper advice. Now, make sure you check out these videos on more useful tips, tricks, and information for Crohn's and colitis. Hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a video, as well as leaving a like and a comment if you enjoyed this and found it useful. And I can't wait to see you in the next episode. Have a great day.